my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44, but it does not really matter. Today it's going to be another declutter. As you can see, I have my powder products in front of me. So to be on the safe side, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up. I think it's going to be a long one because I will probably swatch, but I will try to go quickly. But I will probably fail as well. So yeah, what do we have here? We have my face powders, we have basically setting powders, we have bronzers, highlighters and blushes. And the biggest part is here, there, and that's the blushes. So yeah, let me kind of make room for everything. And I think I'm going to start with the powders because I hope that I can go through them quicker. So I needed another powder. So yeah, let me, yes, wow.
Okay, let's use the blushes for last, I think. Yes, like so. No! Stay there, please. And then the highlighters can go there. No! And then the bronzers can go here.
Something like this, I think. So yeah, so these little pink drawers or pink baskets are what I store my powder products in my drawers. It's not ideal, but it fits. So let's start with something I know I'm going to keep. That's this from Makeup Revolution. This is the matte base powder in P2. And this is actually the one that I use if I need a face powder to blend out my eyeshadow with, for instance. So yeah, that is what I use this for. And it's not going anywhere because, yeah, maybe the color is a little bit too light now, but it doesn't matter. It's great for that, so that's staying. This is from Root Cosmetics. It's a mineral under eye setting powder that I really, really liked when I got it. But I actually don't use it anymore. So I think I'm going to get rid of this. And when I'm getting rid of stuff, let me explain that as well. I am not going to toss unless it is bad. But please don't ask me in the comment section for my used makeup, because I won't send it to you. I thought about doing a giveaway with it, but I'm just not going to. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give my immediate family and friends, people that I know personally, I'm giving them free first pick. Everything that is left after that, if I can sanitize it, I will be donating it to a shelter for, well, women and men who want to get out of an abusive relationship. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do. The Root Cosmetics powder I'm going to declutter. It's not a bad powder, it's just I don't use it. Then the Hourglass Veil, it's actually, I think it's empty. There is a tiny bit left. But if I want to get it out, I think I need to wreck the component. But still, this is just also a little bit of sentimental value, because this was a present from one of you guys. And when I got this, I almost cried. So I am, even though I'm not getting anything out of this, I think I still can though. But I am keeping it just for that reason, because it just meant so much to me. So this one is staying. And you are also staying, yes. This is from Flower Beauty. This is the Miracle Glow Satin Finishing Powder. And it survived the last declutter. But I haven't used it since then. So I actually think I'm going to get rid of this. The powder isn't bad. Yeah, it still smells normal. The powder isn't bad. It's just that I don't use this one at all. So I'm going to give this one away. Okay, next is my Juvia's Place I Am Magic Setting Powder in White Sands. Now, I kind of have a little bit of a love-hate relationship with this, because on the one hand, I like it. On the other hand, it makes my makeup look so cakey so quickly. It survived my last declutter because I wanted to try it out a little bit more. Now, I have been trying it out and it's okay for me in summer, but I don't know, maybe when I use this, I need to use a why are my nails weird? I don't know. I need to use a specific amount, because if it is too hot outside, I need too much to set my face with. I think I'm going to get rid of this, because it's almost a love-hate relationship with this. There are not a lot of powders that I use, and I did try this one out, and it's not a really bad setting powder, but for me, for what I like with my texture and all that, it is just not, no. I'm going to get rid of it. Yes, that feels much better. Let's go to this one from Catrice, the All Matte Plus Shine Control Mattifying Powder. This is a pressed powder. I actually used it recently again. Because I did find that I loved pressed powders more in winter than loose powders. Was that good English? Probably not. As you can see, I have hit pan. I'm just going to use this up. And maybe I will... Yeah, like pressed powder, so I don't know, I'm going to keep it anyway. Here I have one from Kiko Milano, which is the Waterflower Magic Perfecting Powder. This is not going anywhere. This is very, very pretty. You can use this as a finishing powder. And when you swatch it like this, it's very blah. But it's gorgeous if you put it on the skin with the buffing technique. And you can also set your face with this. So that is what I want to try. It's not going anywhere. I do have to say, though, that when I first got it and I opened it, it smelled very strongly of flowers. And I don't really like that. So let's go next then to Kiko. As loose powder. This is the component that it comes in. And it is, I don't know who thought this was a good idea, but it's atrocious. So what did I do? I bought a component on AliExpress and I put this powder in here. I really, really like this powder. It is one of my favorite setting powders. It's very pretty. It's very finely milled. And it has a tiny hint of a sheen without making your face glittery. It's just a very, very pretty powder. I actually don't know if they... have this in a pressed form. Maybe this is the one in the pressed form. I don't know, but it's not going anywhere. But the component, oh my lord, it's atrocious. Okay, let's next go to this from Fenty. This is the setting powder, Pro Filter setting powder in butter. I really like this powder. And that is actually, this is the reason that I'm getting rid of the Juvia's Place. They kind of look similar, but this one is just way better in my opinion. Especially if you are older. I have said this before, I even like this one better than the Hourglass. So, yeah, and that is saying something. So it's staying. These two are staying as well. I know they are staying. This is the Revolution Loose Powder Infinite with niacinamide. I love niacinamide. This is a very pretty powder. It is the same as the Kiko Milano one, only this does not have a sheen. This is a mattifying powder. Also very, very finely milled. Yeah. Great, great drugstore powder. Especially if you cannot get your hands on the one from Kiko. This is definitely one to check out. And then here we have my Revolution Skin Finish. That could technically be in the highlighter section as well. Because I use this as a finishing powder to buff all over. To give your face a very, very pretty glow. But when you build it up, it is a very pretty, as you can see on my finger, pretty highlighter. With a denser, smaller brush. So not going anywhere either. So yeah, not a lot in the powder section that was decluttered. But yeah, what can you do about it? It is just the way that it is. So let me put everything back in its place. I do need to go in front actually. So yeah. Okay. And this is... it's basically sentimental. I could theoretically get rid of this because it's only the component. Maybe I can, I think I need to open it up. This is what's annoying. There is still product in here. I just cannot get it out, which is kind of, see, almost nothing comes out, which is kind of annoying. So I am going to toy with this some more, but for now it is just staying. So yeah, three powders decluttered, the rest is stay. I actually thought I would get rid of more, but apparently not. And yeah, this is basically just the component with a little bit in it that I need to throw over in the other thingamajingy. So yeah, okay. Let's next go to bronzers, because I have them here. Let's also go to this one then. This is my contour palette from Essence. It is in the shade Light for Lighter Skin. It's not going anywhere. I don't use this side, but I do use this side. And this is the perfect powder contour for me. It's very, very pretty. I don't use it often, but I do like it. So it is not going anywhere. Let's see if I can kind of fit everything there that I'm keeping. Okay, let's go to this one. This is not going anywhere either. This is my Kiko Milano bronzer in Warm Honey from the Unexpected Paradise line. This is a yellowy bronzer. And I really, really love this on me. So I know I'm going to keep this one. So I really, really love this one. This is the one from Ame. I got this in a style tone box and it actually survived the last declutter. It's a very pretty shade. It is a little bit more of a, almost a reddish pink, but on me lately it's not that pretty. I'm just not reaching for it, and ever since my last declutter I think I used it once and I really did not like the color on my skin, so I'm going to pass that one along as well. Let's go to this one, the Bahama Mama. I do like this one. I think the color is very pretty as well. It's a very nice, is it a medium? I don't know. I don't know what kind of color this is, but it's a very nice bronzer. I do want to use this lightly though, with a fluffy brush. I think it's prettier on me, but that is also because I don't really like an overly bronzed face. But I do like the fact that I can use this in summer as well. I do feel that it is maybe a tad too dark for me, but I am going to keep it for now. So I kind of want to put it there. So yeah. Let's go to this one then. The Natasha Denona Bronze and Glow. This was a gift. And I don't use it. That's the trouble. I'm not into glowy bronzers at all anymore. It is pretty though. This shade on me, it's almost a little bit too red for what I like. Now, my undertone is neutral, but I prefer a little bit of the, I don't know, the cooler tones almost. Yeah, is yellowy a cooler tone of a warmer? I don't know. I feel like this is a warmer bronzer because it's a bit more red, but it's just not pretty on me, I feel. And I actually think I'm going to pass this one along to someone who will love this because it's just sitting in my collection and I'm just really, really not using it. So it's going to go with actually pain in my heart. It's the reason that I kept it the last time is because I got it as a gift. And I have a very hard time giving away a gift, especially something like this. You know, it came from one of you from America and it just means so, so much to me that I kind of feel like I should keep it, but I know I'm not going to use it. So, yeah, you know? So, yeah. That is basically the reason. Let's go to this one from Ofra. This is the Samantha March collab. And as you can see, I put brr on it and here the name because all the components look the same. I do like the aesthetic of the component when they are very new, but as you can see, when you have them for a little while longer, they are dirty. This is a very pretty bronzer. And you have a shimmer side and you have a matte side. I don't really use the shimmer side on its own. I usually kind of go like that and swirl. And then I get a little bit of a satin sheen, which I like. And this is the maximum amount of redness, basically, that I want in a bronzer. This one is redder than this one. I don't know if it shows on camera. But this one is a little bit, almost a little bit more orangey, I think, than this one. And this one is just more, yeah, it's more flattering on me. So if you have the Natasha Denona one and you think it's too red, you can, but you do kind of like that tone, you can try this one, the shade River. It's not going anywhere. I really like the formula of the Ofra face products, so it's staying. And then let's go to this one from X Revolution in the shade Demo. This is what it looks like. I think they have one that's a little bit lighter. Let's put it here because I can. This is also, I don't know, it's almost I almost want to say cooler neutral. I don't know if that is correct though, but it is a very pretty shade. I also really like the formula and I am going to keep this one. And I do use it often actually. Then the Catrice Sunglow Matte Bronzing Powder. This was one of my favorites for a very long time. I don't know if you can see it, but I do have a dip in it. And it's just, yeah, it's a lighter one. I like this one in winter a lot. I'm going to keep it because it's the only Catrice bronzer that I have. And I do really, really like this bronzer. So it is staying as well. Then I have these two left. And I actually know that these are both going to go because these are both shimmer bronzers. And I'm just not into shimmer bronzers anymore. This one is a very pretty shade. So the tone I really like. Can you see? Maybe, I don't know. But the, it's hairs. The tone I really do like, but it's just too shimmery for what I like, actually. So yeah, it kind of reminds me a little bit of, it's between these two. But I'm just not using it, so it's going to go away. This one is a little darker, which is also a very pretty, pretty color. But again, because it is too, I'm sorry for the shine of my watch. Maybe I should swatch there somewhere. It's going to go as well. So yeah, bronzer wise, this is what I'm keeping. And here I have the things that I am getting rid of. Okay, so those were the powders. It's nice that it can fit in here. I like that. So bronzer and powder is done now. Yes, let's get another kind of little basket tubby. And let me see what I can do with the highlighters. Let's start with this one, which is a face palette. I do really like this one. And what I actually like, I like the bronzer in here. Where did I have the shade demo? Was it here? I think it was. No, it was here. That's the shade demo. Let me get the shade demo because I want to compare swatch them there and there. So here I have them. Let me put them here. So they are close, but is it demo that is more? Now I'm confused, really. God damn it. Okay, so this is yes, and this is yes. Okay. A little bit more. I want to build it up a bit. Okay. So the shades are, can you see? The shades are close, but demo is a little bit more orange almost compared to the first one from the palette. I do like this one though, so I am... yeah, and I do use it, especially in winter. I like it. Then the highlighter. Yeah, the highlighter is okay. And the blush is okay too. I'm not really into a pink blush with a golden sheen. But the quality is nice. So when I grab this... Where am I? There. When I grab this palette, it is usually for the bronzer and for the highlighter. Not so much the blush. But I do like it. So I am going to hold on to it for now. Let's put it here with the bronzers. And the bronzer though. It's actually, I think, the only real face palette that I have. So yeah. Highlighters. Okay, let's start with this one. This one is not going anywhere. It's my BH Duo Light Highlighter Palette. It is staying. So let's put it there. Let's put it here because I know it's not going anywhere. Then the Bella Pierre Heatwave Highlighter Palette. I really do like that palette. Where's my spray? Let's see if I can kind of clean everything up a little bit. I do really like this. I like the quality of it, but I usually don't grab for it. If I do grab for it, it is basically for this one, which is a little bit more of an orangey one. And maybe for this one, but that's basically it. The formula is very nice though. I got this in a Styleton box as well. Let me swatch it here. So the formula is very pretty and there are some very pretty shades in here. I just don't really use them. So I actually think I'm going to... Yeah, I'm going to give this one away. So it's going to go in here, which is going to be the declutter pile. Now these three are from Soda Makeup. I got one in PR. I don't remember which one I got in PR. I actually think it's this one, but I don't remember. I got one in PR and the other two I bought. Soda Makeup was a cheaper brand that came to the drugstore here. I think it was last year. Last year summer? Lord, the time flies. But anyway, it was I have eyeshadow palettes from them. And I also have, well, as you see, these. The formula is actually pretty nice. I just don't use these at all. At all. And I also, you know, and that is the trouble with having a channel. I cannot really recommend these because I cannot tell you where to get them, you know. So while the formula is very, very nice, and if you see them, they're definitely worth grabbing. I am going to get rid of all of them because, yeah, I cannot tell you where to get them, you know? So that's kind of a shame, actually. Okay. What do I have here? Let's go to these. I have here one from AliExpress from Miss Rose in the shade, I think the shade is 8. And again, this is a very pretty champagne-y blush. Really? Now I want to say bronzer, highlighter. That was the word I was looking for. It's very, very pretty, but I have not touched it for quite some time. And I am going to get rid of this because, yeah, this was kind of a dupe for my over ones. But I have other formulas I like more, I think. Am I on the fence on this? Let's reserve judgment for just a second. I have it here. Let's build it up. Because I kind of want to compare swatch. Let's compare swatch with this one, which is from Ofra. It's the All of the Lights, because I did not really know which one I wanted. So I thought, this is not a good swatch, really. So I thought, let me get these. So here I have Pillow Talk, which is way too icy for me. Then I have, yeah, that's almost the same, isn't it? This is, what is it, Rodeo Drive? I don't know. Star Island. Yeah, so Pillow Talk is too light for me. Star Island is nice. Blissful is too dark. And Rodeo Drive I can make work as well. So basically these two I can make work. This one is too icy for me now. And this one is too dark. So, yeah, but here they are. This one is very pretty on top of a blush. I could use this. This one I can use in my summer color. So basically the one that I can really nicely use now is this one. But I do really, really love the formula. This is not going anywhere. So yeah, I think that is it. Let me build this one up a little bit more. But these two are kind of similar. So this one is going to go and Ofra is staying. This one from e.l.f. is also staying. This is quite new, actually. This is from the Retro Paradise collection. I got this as a gift as well. This is a face and body highlighter. And it is not, when you swatch it, it's not, yeah, it's kind of sheer. It's also kind of glittery. But it is so pretty on the skin when you put it on with a brush. So it's not going anywhere. Again, it's very, very new. Now, these two aren't going anywhere either. These are from Nomad Studio 54 collection. These were both PR as well. I have Disco Nights and Hot Shot. Hot Shot is not really a color that I use. It is basically a pink with a blue shift. It's very, very pretty. But this is what I pull in, for instance, for eyeshadow looks. This one I do use also as a face highlighter. Or a blush topper. Because when I do, I don't know, kind of an orangey look or something like that. This is gorgeous to put on top of an orangey blush. To make it a little bit more shiny. I really, really like this. And I use this quite a lot lately, at least in eye looks as well. So that's staying too. I have this left. So let me grab this one. Okay, let's go to the one from Catrice. The 3D Glow in Icy Glaze. It survived the last declutter, but it is just too icy. I have a white and I have a blue and they can kind of swirl. It's just, guys, it's way too light for me. The formula is very, very nice. And if you are fair, I think it will be very, very pretty on you. But this for me, it just needs to go. Oh, wait, here was my highlighter declutter box thingamajingy. I have here X-Revolution shade Strobe. And this is very pretty as well. So here's the shade Strobe, which is just a gorgeous. It's so pretty. And the formula is so, so nice. So it's not going anywhere. Does that fit? Yeah, for now it fits. So that's good. Let's go to this one, which is also new. It's a Starstruck Triple Baked Highlighter from iHeartRevolution. I actually got this in, what was it, the gift with purchase, one of those mystery bags. And it's actually very nice. So this is like Pillow Talk. I have Pillow Talk here. But it is more pink. So on me, this is perfect now. So if I want to get the same vibe, I grab this one. Maybe I can use Pillow Talk in winter. I don't know. But this one is less icy. It's more pink. And it's a very, very nice formula. This is also new. So it's not going anywhere. Then I have these two left. Let's go to this one from MUA. It's a highlighter kit in a pink luster. So it's actually a twofer. So you get here the powder, which is gorgeous. It's very, very pretty. And then below that you get cream. Now, can you see what it looks like? I actually think I'm going to toss this. Because when I got this, I wasn't really into cream products. I also got this as a gift, actually. I wasn't into cream products and I did not know how to use this. And I have been digging my finger in, trying to get it to work. And I just think that I need to toss it just to be on the safe side. The shade is very, very pretty. Pink Luster. So maybe if I see just the shade Pink Luster from MUA, I will grab it. Because the formula is amazing. But this one is going to go in the bin. To be on the safe side. It's going to go here though, because it's going to go away. Then the last one I have here is Natasha Denona Diamond and Glow. This was also a present. This survived my last declutter for the same reason that the Bronze and Glow stayed. It's because it was a present. And it... guys, I don't use this. I think I used this 3 times. It's just not pretty on me. So, yeah, this one is very, very glittery and very, very sheer. So, it doesn't do a lot. This one is pretty, but on me, the only thing you see on me is the gold. Which is, let's do it like this. Which is a shame, because if the gold shimmer wasn't in there and it was just that pink that was in here, I think I would have hit pan on it already. It's just that the fact that that gold sheen that is in there, it's just not flattering on me. So I am with, yeah, I'm going to pass this one along as well with pain in my heart. It's very, very difficult, but I am going to, because I just, you know, I just don't use it. And while I love my makeup, I also kind of want other people to enjoy it, you know. And I actually think that I can make someone very, very happy with those products. So yeah, it's going to go away. So basically, you need to go here then. This is what is going from the highlighters. And this is what is staying. This was the part of my highlighters, bronzers and powders. Because it is... way, way, way too long, so the blushes will be in a separate video. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I will leave my makeup collection playlist on the end screen for your viewing pleasure. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.